The sad passing of His Majesty King Bhumibol Adulyadej, King Rama the Ninth of Thailand, marks the end of an era. This extraordinary monarch was truly the heart of the nation, deeply respected and universally loved by his subjects. Born in Cambridge, Massachusetts, in the United States on December the 5th, 1927, he was the youngest son of His Royal Highness Prince Mahidol Adulyadej, the Prince of Songkhla, and his wife Mom Sangwan, later Her Royal Highness Princess Srinakarin, the Princess Mother. His U.S. birth certificate reads simply, Baby Songkhla, waiting for his uncle King Rama the 7th to choose a suitably auspicious name, Bhumibol Adulyadej, meaning strength of the land, incomparable power. In 1933, when he was barely 6 years old, his recently widowed mother took her family to Switzerland, where His Majesty continued his education at the École Nouvelle de la Suisse Romande in Lausanne. It was while in Switzerland that his lifelong interest in photography was kindled, and since then, His Majesty has rarely been seen without his camera close by. In 1942, His Majesty fell in love with jazz and started to play the saxophone. The love of jazz music and his musical prowess led him to become a highly respected and prolific composer and performer. In Paris, he met Mom Ratchawong Sirikit Kitiakorn, daughter of the Thai ambassador to France at the time. While completing his formal education in Switzerland prior to taking up his royal duties, the young Bhumibol was involved in a serious road accident. While he was hospitalized in Lausanne, Sirikit visited him frequently. She met his mother, who asked her to continue her studies nearby so that Bhumibol could get to know her better. Bhumibol selected for her a boarding school in Lausanne, and a quiet engagement followed, and they were married on the 28th of April 1950, just a week before his coronation. Following the end of World War II, the family returned to live in Thailand. The royal couple were blessed with four children. Princess Ubonrat Ratchakanya, His Royal Highness Crown Prince Maha Wathiralongkorn, Her Royal Highness Princess Maha Chakri Sirinthorn, and Her Royal Highness Princess Chulaborn Walailak. The coronation took place on the 5th of May 1950, when the new king publicly pledged that he would, quote, reign with righteousness for the benefit and happiness of the Siamese people, end quote. A promise he was to keep for the next 7 decades. Delivering his promise to the Thai people meant the creation of over 4,000 royal projects, including large-scale irrigation projects in rural areas, the Hoi Ongkot Land Reform Project, and the Royal Medical Team, involving Bhumibol's private physicians, who accompanied him on village tours when they were encouraged to provide medical care for local residents. Perhaps the best known and most enduring of his innovations became known as the sufficiency economy theory, an alternative to the export-oriented policies adopted by elected governments. From this list of projects, it's clear that His Majesty's focus was very much on his rural subjects, and it would be fair to say that he rarely seemed happier or more comfortable than when he was in deep conversation with villagers around the country. While His Majesty's passing is met with great sadness both in Thailand and around the world, the collective grief is measured by the gratitude of people who consider themselves so fortunate to have lived during the reign of such an extraordinary king, the heart of a nation.